Assalamu alaikum everyone. Welcome to database course. In today's lecture, we will learn about different join operations in relational algebra. In our previous lecture, we have discussed different set operations of relational algebra, which includes union, intersection, set difference, Cartesian product, and rename. We also did some tasks related to these set operations in our previous lecture. In today's lecture, we will learn about join operations in relational algebra. We have theta join, equi join, natural join, outer join, and then outer join has further three types: left outer join, right outer join, and full outer join. So in today's lecture, we will learn about all these joins with examples. First, what is a join? Join is a binary operation. It means that we can apply join on more than one table. It combines two relations to form a new relation. So we apply join on two tables at a time, and it gives us a new relation or a table which includes the data from both tables. It is a combination of Cartesian product and selection statement. So in our previous lecture, we have seen an example of Cartesian product and selection statement. First, we apply Cartesian product on two tables, but in the result, we get a lot of extra rows. So we apply selection statement on that Cartesian product result to get only those rows which are required. So we can also do the same operation with the help of join. There are various forms of join operations. We have theta join, equi join, natural join, and outer join. First, we have theta join. So we write theta join with this join notation. The theta join operation defines a relation that contains tuples satisfying the condition theta from the Cartesian product of R and S. So in theta join, we have two tables R and S. We apply Cartesian product between two tables, and from the result of Cartesian product, we get only those rows or tuples which satisfy this theta condition. So this theta is basically a condition that we apply on the result of Cartesian product of R and S. Theta may contain one of the comparison operators. So in condition, we can use less than equals to, greater than equals to, equals to or not equals to. We can use all these operators in theta. Here you can see that this is the Cartesian product with selection statement, and it is equals to the R theta join S. So when we have Cartesian product of R and S and we apply some theta condition on the result of Cartesian product, it is actually equals to the R theta join S. They both have same meaning. We get same result from both expressions. Here we have an example of Cartesian product. If you remember, in our previous lecture, we have seen this example in which we want to list the names and comments of all clients who have viewed a property for rent. So we have a client table and viewing table. In client table, we have information about client, and in viewing table, we have information about which clients have viewed which property. So when we take a Cartesian product between these two tables, we get this resulting relation. In Cartesian product, we know that we multiply each row of the first table with every row of the second table. Now you can see that we have a lot of extra rows here which we do not require. So what we do, we apply a selection statement on this whole expression. Here we have applied a selection statement on the result of Cartesian product that the client.client number is equals to the viewing.client number. So from this table, we select only those rows where this client number is equal to this client number. So for example, here we have this second row. Here you can see that it satisfies this condition. This CR76 is equals to CR76. Then we can check further if this CR56 also satisfies this condition. So we will include it. This CR56 is also satisfying this condition. This CR56 is also satisfying this condition. And then this CR62 is also satisfying this condition. Here we also have CR62. So you can see that we applied this selection statement on the result of Cartesian product. So you can see that we get all those five rows in our resulting table. So this is the combination of Cartesian product and selection statement. Now if we want to write this whole expression in terms of theta join, what we will do, we will write it as, first we will write the project operation. We have this client number, then we have F name, then we have L name. From which table? Client table, because we are just selecting these columns. Okay, next we will apply theta join. So we will write the join operator, and here we have to write the condition. So we will join them on the condition that where the client dot client number means the client number of client table is equals to viewing dot client number. So it means that the client number from viewing table should be equal to the client number from client, and then we will write this expression. So we have project client number, then we have property number. I am just writing the short forms, P number and comment. From which table? Viewing table. So this will be the expression. We have first table client, from which we select client number, F name and L name with the help of project operator. And then we will take theta join. We will apply theta join with the condition that client.client number is equals to viewing.client number, this condition actually. And then we will write the name of the second table with the column names that we want in our result. So these both expressions are equal, and we will get the same result from both these expressions. Next, we have another example of theta join. Here we have a table of shoes and bags. Now suppose that we want to purchase shoes and bags, but we have a condition that the price of shoes must be less than the price of bags. We want to buy both of these products, but we want that the price of this shoes is less than price of bags. So first we will apply the cross product or Cartesian product on these two tables, and we will get this result. So here you can see that we have multiplied Metro 4000 with Limelight and Sapphire. Then we have Stylo 5000 and we multiplied it with Limelight and Sapphire row, and again for Bata 2000 we multiplied it with these two rows. So we get this Cartesian product of shoes and bags. Now we have a condition that price of shoes must be less than the price of bags. So we apply the theta join, and in the theta condition we write it as shoes dot price is less than bags dot price. Now from this table we will satisfy this condition and then we will get our relation, new relation. So the shoe store price is less than bag store price. This first row does not satisfy this condition. Next, for metro we have 4000 and sapphire 5000. So this second row actually satisfies this condition and we will include it in our resulting table. Next, we have 5000 is not less than 3000, then this 5000 is equals to 5000. This is also not satisfying the condition. Then we have 2000 less than 3000. So we have price of shoes less than price of bags. We will include it. And for this row, we also have 2000 less than 5000. So we have included these two rows as well. So in this way, we can apply condition on the Cartesian product and then we get the result. This is an example of theta join. Next we have equi-join. So in the case where the predicate theta contains only equality, the term equi-join is used instead. So when we talk about theta, we said that it can include different comparison operators like less than, greater than equals to, not equals to. So if theta contains only equals to operator, that we call as equi-join. So for example, here we have a customer table and agent table. And if we want to check all the customers and agents that belong to same country, so we want to apply a condition on the country fields that they must be equal. This is our joining condition. First we will write the name of customer table, then we will apply equi-join and we have a condition that the C country of customer is equals to this country of agent. And then we write the name of the second table. So we are actually joining these two tables on this condition. But here we have only the result, but in the back end it will be first the cross product, and from the cross product we apply this condition and we get this result. So here if we check, first we have UK, we find UK in agent table as well, get this in our resulting table. Next we have US in customer, but we cannot find US in agent table, so it will not be included. Next we have China, so when we will multiply this row with this row, we will satisfy this condition that the C country of customer is equal to the A country of agent. And this row is also included in our resulting table. So we have equi-join when we use this equals to operator. Next we have natural join. The natural join is an equi-join of two relations R and S over all common attributes X. One occurrence of each common attribute is eliminated from the result. So natural join is actually an equi-join. We apply equal operator on the columns of the two tables. The condition is that the two columns must be same in both tables. And when we combine with the natural join, we write the common attribute only once in our resulting table. The degree of a natural join is sum of the degrees of relations R and S less than the number of attributes in X. So because we write the common attribute only once, the degree of the result of natural join is sum of the degrees of relation R and S minus X. Because we will write the common column once, so if the degree of first table is 2 and the degree of second table is also 2, so in the result, the degree of natural join will be 3. Because the common column from the two tables will be written only once in our result of natural join. Common columns must have same name in each table. So in natural join, it is must that the two tables must have a column that have same name so that it can apply equi-join condition on that same column. For example, here we have again the example of the clients who have viewed the property. Now from the both tables, you can see that we have a common column with the same column name, client number. So we apply natural join on the two tables, client and viewing. And for natural join, we don't need to write the condition like we write in case of equijoin, or we write in case of theta join, because it will identify the common column from the two tables and it will apply equijoin operation on two tables. It is actually applying this join on a condition that client number dot client name is equals to viewing dot client number. So it is applying equijoin on this client number column. They both are same, they both have same name. This is the natural join and it identifies the common column by itself. And both columns must have same name. We don't actually use natural join a lot. We only use it once it is written that you must use it, because it can happen that the two tables can have more than one same column. There can be another column city with the same name in both tables. So in that case, the result will be different, because then it will compare the values of both client number and the city as a pair. So it is better not to use natural join. Next, we have outer join. For outer join, we have three different types: left outer join, right outer join, and full outer join. So in left outer join, it is a join in which tuples from R that do not have matching values in the common attributes of S are also included in the result relation. Missing values in the second relation are set to null. So when we apply left outer join on two tables R and S, we get all those values that are common in both R and S plus those values of R that do not have matching values in S. So we actually get all the values of R. For example, here we have a statement that produce a status report on property viewings. So here we have the table for property or for rent, in which we have all the property that is available for rent, and then we have this viewing table in which we have the information about which client has viewed which property. Now we want to produce a report in which we want to see all the properties that have been viewed or that have not been viewed. We want actually a report. So in that case, we will apply left outer join between property for rent and viewing. So first we have property for rent with few columns, and we apply left outer join with viewing. We have a condition here that property for rent dot property number is equals to viewing dot property number. So we are actually joining these two tables on the condition that this property number from property for rent must be equal to property number from viewing. And we will apply this condition, of course, on the Cartesian product of these two tables. So if we find that which rows satisfies this condition, so we have this EA14. So we find the matching value in viewing table as well, so we will include it in our result. Then we have PL94, we don't have PL94 here, then we have PG4, we find PG4 here, we will include it, then we have PG36, okay, we find it, we will include it, then for PG29, PG16, we don't find any matching value in viewing. But because this is a left outer join, so it will include all those tuples from the left table that do not have matching values in the viewing table. So we will also include PL94, PG21 and PG16, like here. We have PL94, we have PG16 and PG21. Now if you see these rows, they have null here because we do not find any matching value of this property in the viewing result, because they are not being viewed, so we don't have their information in the viewing table. So we just write null in front of these properties because we don't have these values from this table. So from this table we can find out that which properties have been viewed by which client and which properties have not been viewed at all. Next we have right outer join. So right outer join is actually the opposite of left outer join. In right outer join, we have tuples from S that do not have matching values in the common attributes of R are also included in the result relation. Missing values in the first relation are set to null. So when we apply right outer join, we include all those values that are common, and then we also include all those tuples in S that do not have matching values in R. And we write null against those values of S. Like here we have two tables as customers and order. Now we want to see that which customer has placed order. So if we apply this right outer join on the common column that we have this CID, now we will see that we have this 111 in customer table as well. Then we have this 12 in customer table as well. And this 14, for this we cannot find any matching value in the left table. But this is included in our resulting table, because this is the right outer join. We will include all those values from the right table that we do not find any matching value in the left table. And against that record, we have null. For the order number 103, who has been placed by the customer ID 14, we do not find this customer in the customer table. Maybe he is doing shopping or he is placing order for the first time, so we don't have his information in the customer table. So this table can tell us that this order is placed by the customer for which we don't have information in our customer table. So this is actually opposite of left join. Here we include all the tuples of right table. Next we have full outer join. So in full outer join, it keeps all tuples in both relations, pairing tuples with nulls when no matching tuples are found. So full outer join is a combination of left outer and right outer. In full outer join, we include all the matching values of common attribute plus all the remaining values of each table. Here we have full outer example. Again, we have taken the customer in order. For full join, we have this notation. We just have these lines on the symbol of simple join operation. Okay, so when we apply full outer join, first we will add the matching values. So 11 is present in both tables, 12 is present in both tables. Now this 13 is not present in the order table, but we have included it with the null values in the resulting table. Similarly, you can see that here we have included these two rows, but for 14 we do not find any matching value in the customer table, but we have included it here and we have null values against this record because we don't have information of this customer in our customer table. So we get this result of full outer join. We can get information that this customer has not placed any order, or this order ID has been placed by the customer that don't have information in our customer table. So actually full outer join is a combination of left join and right join. Okay, here we have some practice questions on the Dreamhouse database schema. So we will perform each one by one. These are the database instance of Dreamhouse. Okay, so first question we have is, show the property details of owner Joey. First of all, when the query is given, we have to find that what we need to see. So we need to see the property details. From which table we can get the property details? We can get the property details from this property for rent table. Next, of which owner? We have the owner information. We have the first name of owner, which is Joey. So we can get this information from this private owner table. So now we know that we need to get information from both these tables. We apply a select condition on private owner table that we want only that record where we have owner Joey. So first, if we apply this select, and in select statement we will write that f name is equals to Joey. And we have applied this condition on private owner table. So we will write here private owner. And then we have to join it with property for rent. Here we will write the table name of property for rent. Now we will join them. We will use the join operator on the condition that the owner number from property for rent is equals to the owner number of private owner, because you can see that this is the common column from both tables. So we can join these two tables on the base of this common table. So we will write that property for rent dot owner number, I am writing the short forms, is equals to the private owner dot owner number. So this will be the expression. First we apply the select statement of private owner. We get the role, the first name as Joey. Then we will apply the cross, the Cartesian product between these two, and then we apply this condition on the Cartesian product and we will get the required result. So if you see that we have this private owner table, if we apply this condition on this table, so here we have first name. So we will get this row, first row, and then we will multiply it with the property for rent. So we will multiply this row with each row of property of rent, and then we will apply this condition that the owner number from both table must be equal. So we have this owner number C046. We will find the rows which has C046. So we will get this first row. Okay, we will get this first row. So we have find the property that belongs to the owner Joey. Okay, here I have applied the select statement first and then the join operation. But we can do it like this. First we can apply the join operation between these two tables, and then on the join operation, after joining them, we apply the condition that the F name is equals to Joey, like this. So first we will get the result of joining operation based on this condition, and then on that result we will apply this condition that the first name is Joey. So we will get the required result. So in this case, first it will take the cross product of these two tables. It will multiply each row of property for rent with the each row of private owner. Then it will apply this condition. We will get only those rows where this owner number is matching with this owner number. And then from that result, we will apply this condition that the first name is equals to Joey. And then we will get this result. So you can write it in both ways. We will get the same result in each case. Next, we have show the name of staff member who has done registration for client number CR56. So we want to get the information about registration. So in registration, we also have this client number, and then we want the staff name. So staff name we can get from the staff table. Here in both tables, if you see, we have this staff number as common column. So we will apply the join operation based on the staff number. And then we want the name of the staff that has done registration for client number CR56. So we can apply this condition on the registration table that select client number as CR56 from registration table. Then we will apply the join operation on the condition that registration dot staff number is equals to staff dot staff number, and then we will write the name of the second table, which is staff. First, we have applied this condition on registration table, and then from the result of this, we are multiplying it with the staff table. And here you see we only want to see the name of the staff member. So we will apply projection on the result of this table, and we only want to select the first name from the result. Now you see that from the registration table, we have this selection operation that C number, client number is equals to CR56. So client number is equals to CR56, we get this row. And then we will multiply this row with the staff table, with each row of staff table, and on the condition that this staff number must be equal to this staff number. And then from the result of that, we will only select the first name. Because we have applied this projection operation, we only want to get the first name. So we have this staff number as SG37. We will find the matching value in this row, CG37, and the first name of this staff is N. So we will get in the result as N. Next, we have list branches and properties in same city and any unmatched branches. So here we have to find the branches and properties in the same city plus unmatched branches. We also have to write the city where there is a branch but no properties. So we will write branch table and then we will apply the left outer join. We have condition that branch dot city is equals to property for rent dot city. We are joining the two tables based on this condition, and then here we will write the name of second table, which is property for rent. I am just writing as PFR. When you write the actual relational algebra expressions, you have to write the full name of the table. Okay, so this will be the expression. It will combine both tables based on this condition where we have matching value, plus it will include all those cities where we have branch but not property for rent because we have applied left outer join. So we will have all the cities of branch table, even if they don't have matching city values in property for rent. Next, we have list the cities in which there is a property or branch. We are just joining the two tables on the condition that we have same city. So we have this branch and then we apply this join operation based on branch dot city is equals to property for rent dot city, and then we multiply it with property for rent. So we will get those values where we have same city but we just want to list the city. So we will apply project operator and we can select cities from the result of this expression. We only want to see the common city column. Next, we have the query show the client names and branch numbers in which they have done registration. So we can get the client names from the client table and the branch numbers from this registration number. So we want to see the client names and branch numbers in which they have done registration. Okay, so we are joining this registration table with the client table. Okay, so we can write registration table and here we can write this client table. We have this client number in both tables, so we will apply the join operation on client dot client number is equals to registration dot client number, and then we just want to show the client names and branch number. So we will apply project operator, we will select the fname column and the branch number, so we will select this column branch number. So we join the client and registration table based on this condition and then we apply the project operation because we just want these two columns in our result. So in this session, we have learned about different join operations in relational algebra.